eluded me the first few times I visited Singapore, and now I'm even more determined to find it. Soup tulang. Hi.
Yeah,
you guys serve soup tulang?
Yeah,
here, right?
We got a selling soup tulang.
Can I see how you guys prepare it?
Yeah, I can.
Awesome. So all of it is mutton shanks.
Yeah,
right?
Mutton just shanks. We import from Australia to Singapore. Early morning, we boil the tulang to make soft until fire overs. Then off the fire for half an hour.
Right.
Then take out the oil and make it to sell.
And then you add in your flavoring.
Yeah, flavor inside. Chili powder, tomato ketchup, all together. Something
tomato
like that.
Paste.
Tomato ketchup only, no paste.
Tomato ketchup
and chili.
Ketchup.
We make the chili powder ourselves.
Oh, okay. So is this going to be like a really spicy dish?
Or? Yeah, it's a spicy.
It's a simple process. It just takes a really long
time. A long time to boil it.
Okay, so, I'd love to try one.
Yeah.
And see what it tastes like.
Okay.
Wow. Okay, so the first thing that really strikes at you is the color, right?
Yeah.
It's really red. So is there a reason why it's this color?
Red is a... look like more attractive colors.
Okay, so the color, red actually makes it look more
better,
appetizing.
Yeah, something like look better taste. Okay, you take the bone.
Okay,
eat the flesh first.
Just eat the fat first.
Flesh.
I love this already.
So eat like that.
That was really tender. Like the meat is like falling off the bone, super tender. And really, the only way to eat this is with your hands, right?
Yeah, my fingers are hands.
I mean, there's something very carnal about doing this, you know? Like, feel like you're really carnivorous, like a king of the jungle or something.
Yeah.
So, soup tulang. Mm. If I go to India, will I find soup tulang in India?
No, other countries not available. Actually, it's only in Singapore only can get it.
So this is an Indian Singapore dish?
Yeah.
Right? So how did it start here?
45 years ago, people buy the mutton in a one piece. So they cut out the flesh. And the bone, they left over the bone, right? So they put in a soup and boil it. Then from there, started to make the tulang.
So this is basically a dish that was created because you had a lot of bones with you. Anyway.
Yeah, left over.
I love the texture. The only drawback is this, there's really no fine way to eat this. You're going to make a mess. And you know what? That's what makes it fun. You know, this is definitely not first date food. Okay, Dean, so what I'm looking forward to is actually the marrow.
You said lose a bowl, see?
And then I just do that?
Yeah, see? You can suck it out. Sometimes you can, if it cannot come out, you can suck it out.
That seems more fun, actually.
Yes.
So is it traditional to have bread with this?
Yeah.
Right. So I'm going to take a piece of bread.
Yeah, I can.
And then dip it into the gravy.
Yeah.
Look at that red color, man. And then get a little bit of the marrow. Spread it out like a really fancy pate.
Oh, the taste.
Wow. Man, that marrow is like on fire, man. That's crazy. Wow, even if you don't like mutton, you're gonna like the marrow. No kidding.
The energy you get from here. Even the sportsman, bodybuilder, all they like to eat the bone marrow.
So, see, there's good in eating cholesterol,
They like to,
I mean, I'm not going to do any bodybuilding soon, but it's nice to know that it's quite helpful to have marrow.
Bone marrow is the best.
It's confirmed. Soup tulang is a dish after my own heart. I love its rich, meaty flavors, the fact that it can only be found in Singapore, and even its electric red color. But my favorite part is how it came to be. This dish is yet another example of how using what others think of as scraps can make a delicious and unique dish. It's inspiring me to do the same.